This is TWiT.
What if I wanted to be able to project these games? What if I wanted something that I could take on that car trip, that Thanksgiving trip, that holiday trip? That
impossible.
No. Totally not, bro. Totally not, bro. Whoa. And actually, I'm going to need a little help here. If you could, we've got this. This is a super secret panel. Yeah, we're going to set
Dang,
this down.
Look
this
at
is,
that.
This is going to allow you to do a first look at a device that I got this past week. And I got to say, again, they sent this to me. I was a little skeptical because I've seen a lot of Pico projectors, and they're kind of cool, except...
It's better than not having one, but it's not something that you always want to... use in the way you think you would, because they just don't quite get there.
I love the claims. It's sort of like, this will fill the room with sound with 2 watts, and it can be a 50-inch picture as long as you're in complete darkness.
Yes, complete darkness. Absolutely.
This is not that. This is actually a collaboration between Mars and Anker. Now, Anker is known for making battery packs. That's what they do. So what they've done is they've created a little unit that's battery-powered, and it's actually a 3,000-lumen projector.
Dang.
This is not just visible in a dark room. 500 ANSI lumens, which is the equivalent of 3,000 lumens. It uses a 3,000 LM LED lamp, 1280 by 800, so they call it 800p, but it will scale down high resolution, so it'll work. A dual 10-watt speakers. So this actually is... really loud. You could be in like a hotel room and fill the room with just the speakers.
And that's through the sides, I assume?
Through the sides.
Firing out the sides.
But it also has audio out, and I love this part. It has Bluetooth. So, for example, my favorite are the Fugu speakers, which will pair with each other.
Put them out in the corners.
Put them out in the corners, and you've got surround sound off of this little unit.
That's
also,
cool.
almost 20 amp hour battery, 19,500 milliamp hour battery. That's good for running this thing at about full for about 3 hours. I mean, so it will get you through a movie. Also, wireless connectivity. It's 2.4 and 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi, 802.11 ABGN, as well as running Android. So this is Android inside. This actually would be good for all that Android. Yeah, and you know, they've thought about things like since the prototype, because I saw the prototype at CES a while back, they used to have a lens cap. And I remember someone at the booth was saying, well, lens caps are nice, but they get lost, and then now the lens will get forever dirty. Well, what they did was they just did that, and that's also the on-off switch, which I'm like, oh, okay,
smart.
Clever.
Now, but it doesn't look like it goes all the way down. That's enough
clearance for
the actual lens, though.
Now, as this warms up, you're going to see how bright this thing is. I like the legwork that they've done into the design, because what they've done is they've created what I think is sort of an idiot-proof projector. Now, when you're setting up a projector, what's one of the nastiest problems that you're going to have? It's going to be the aspect.
Exactly. It might be skewed a little bit, or it might be a little wobbled to the side or whatever.
Unless you're hitting it straight on, the picture just won't work right. This will actually do automatic fixing, unskewing. So, like, for example, let me get really close here. If I do this, let's see, let's go up. Oh, actually, I wish the screen was higher. If you could see it, you'll see it in the full
review. Oh, I saw it snap a little bit.
Yeah, see how it snaps over? So it's got an accelerometer in there, and what it will do is it will actually automatically fix the angle.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
It's also, you could really finely focus this thing. I like the fact that they've given you this little target. It's like what we use for TWiT.
I don't feel like on the camera it does it justice as far as how bright this is.
Well, yeah, because
this is really bright.
It's super, super bright. I mean, this actually...
And really sharp.
I was using this thing outside. I've never been able to use a Pico projector outside.
Yeah, now, but this has no awareness of the kind of angle of skew of the screen itself. So you still kind of have to go at it face on.
Yeah, it's got to be, you've got to have it at a 90-degree angle to the wall. That's not normally what's the problem. The problem is it's up and down, and then you have to manually fix it. That's all automatic with this. Now, this also, as you can see, because it's Android TV, it's not straight Android, it's Android TV.
I love this thing.
Yeah, I know, right? So I have an HDMI input. I can go from USB, both music and video and pictures, so I could put a slideshow in there and just have it run. It will also do YouTube and any other apps that you can get for Android TV. Now, for example, if I go to YouTube here, there's a voice search, so you can enable voice search. I disabled it at some point, and that really kind of messed me up. But let's see what's popular on YouTube. Oh, there we go. Hey.
Go ahead and use this random Asus phone.
So let's see. I need music. Selena Gomez. I don't know why that's showing up. I do not listen to Selena Gomez. I'm sorry. No, no. Now let me turn this up and you can see how loud this thing is.
In your eyes, that sounds
right?
Really nice.
Right? That's not tinny.
This is amazing. I love this thing. I mean, now, okay, so how big? Like, obviously, this is a pretty small screen.
This is a super small screen. If I used it, let me turn this down a little bit so we don't get copyright.
No, Selena, come back.
Sorry, Selena. Okay. You're done. Right. I was able to project this as a 60-inch picture in a well-lit room.
Okay.
And that's not on a screen. That was on a wall, which is much less reflective than a screen.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, that's nice. That's
really
good.
Nice.
This is brighter than the large projector I used to carry around with. Now, they call it theater quality. I would kind of push back against that because, for me, theater quality is at least 1080p, right?
Yeah.
This does 800p.
Okay.
Yeah, so there's a little bit of that. It's less than 4 pounds. Now, the killer is the price.
150.
No.
160.
No.
165.
We're gonna be doing this a lot. It's $600.
Dang!
Yeah.
No way.
So it's a little high on the price range.
Wow. Okay, that's pricey.
Yeah.
Still.
Actually, here's something else I do want to show you, because I like this. Let me drop back into the menu. Oh, by the way, yes, remote, Bluetooth remote. It's
okay.
Cool. So if I go to screen mirroring, I now have the ability to both with iOS or Android, I can cast. Let me go.
And they're both connected to the same Wi-Fi, or are you casting directly to
this? I am casting directly.
Oh, okay.
So this, it works just like a Chromecast. In fact, I'm connecting right now. Give it a second. Unfortunately, my phone is a little on the slow side, but I did connect this morning, and you're going to connect right now, right? Come on. Right? Right?
You know, a technology show wouldn't be a technology show without
Come on.
Issues.
No, do this.
It's part of the game that we play.
Actually, you should probably try casting to it with yours.
So, but it doesn't have to be on the same Wi-Fi connection, right? Because
no.
With the Chromecast, that's how I had to connect to it. I had to be on the same Wi-Fi.
I can go direct. So I could have this in the car and just go, which is kind of cool. Well, I can see it. I think, you know what? I think actually I may have messed up this morning.
This is how I stall.
Normally this works.
No, I'm not seeing it.
Yeah, okay. So unfortunately for me, I'm using a OnePlus, the casting is kind of hit or miss, and I think the fact that it worked this morning meant that it wasn't going to work on the show.
you spent your one time
I
working
spent it,
for
I
the
spent
day.
It. It'll work again when the cameras
That's
are off.
Okay. I trust you.
Now, you know, aside from the price, though, this is a really well-made unit. I'm not accustomed to seeing portable projectors built so well. It's solid.
Yeah,
doesn't feel like
solid.
It's going to fall apart. I didn't have to baby step. I did drop
on the bottom,
this.
Yeah,
it's called mounting on the bottom.
Yeah, a little mounting screw.
I did accidentally drop this off a table, and it didn't suffer any ill effects. So, I mean, obviously the optics are a bit more hardened than I've expected out of small projectors.
Yeah.
It's just they've done a really good job.
Nice.
Really, really good job. We're going to do a full review. This is just a first look at the Nebula, the Nebula Mars from Anker.
Dang, but that price, though.
Yeah, I know. That's the thing. I mean, if this was like $400, that'd be an easy buy.
That seems...
At $600, it's like, well, that's phone range.
Do But do you need another phone, really?
I need all the phones, Jason.
Okay, good answer.
Yeah. Actually, that's funny because I just upgraded from a OnePlus One to the OnePlus 5. I was like, okay, the One was good, but...
Dang, you held on to that for a while.
Yeah, that was like 3+ years.
Yeah, no kidding.
And
I'm impressed.
Ultimately, what did it was...
Never done that.
It just wouldn't work anymore. It's like, oh, log in, okay.
That'll do it.
Click, 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 click. All right, let me put it down and get some coffee.
That'll do it.
Yeah.